Okay, people, let's start with this verb to be. Yes? El año pasado lo habíamos comenzado, ¿sí? A trabajar, lo comenzamos durante todo el año pasado. En realidad, esto viene de primero, ¿sí? Okay, so this verb to be, very quickly, yes, very quickly, very simple. You know that verb to be is ser o estar. Yes, it has two meanings, ser y estar. And you know that the verb to be is an irregular verb. And cuando lo conjugamos, sí que lo vamos pasando por los diferentes pronombres, no se mantiene siempre be, como es el caso de otros verbos. Yo siempre les digo, por ejemplo, el verbo to play, que cuando lo conjugamos es I play, you play, they play, we play, she plays, he plays, it plays. ¿Yes? Que en general la raíz o el verbo se mantiene igual, solo que le agregamos la S para she, he, it. ¿Sí? Lo mismo otro, por ejemplo, work. I work, you work, they work, we work, she works, he works, it works. ¿Sí? Le agregamos simplemente la S en she, he, it. En el caso del verbo to be, no vamos a decir I be, you be, we be. No, that is a disaster. Yes, that is not okay. So, the verb to be is irregular. Yes? As you can see here. Y a medida que lo vamos conjugando y pasando por los diferentes pronombres, va tomando diferentes formas. I am, she is, he is, it is, and they are, we are, and you are. Yes? Fíjense que cambia. One, two, three. Yes? For example, the COVID-19 is an international pandemia. Yes? Is. We are at home taking classes. Are. I am a patient of high risk because I suffer from asthma. Am. Yes? Is, are, am. Good. Let's go to the negative form. The COVID isn't an international pandemia. We aren't at home taking classes. I am not a patient of high risk because I suffer from asthma. Yes? Le agregamos simplemente el not y ya tenemos la negación. ¿Sí? A veces puedo usarlo en contracción, a veces no. It's okay, no problem. Yes? Asthma is, acá está bien deletreado. En la diapositiva anterior le faltaba la T y la H. Now the interrogative. ¿Se acuerdan cómo hacíamos el interrogative? This way. Is the COVID-19 an international pandemia? ¿Qué sucede? El verbo, en vez de aparecer después del sujeto, pasa adelante. Are we at home taking classes? Am I a patient of high risk because I suffer from asthma? Yes, the verb goes at the beginning. Yes, as you can see here. Good. And the answers. Because if we have this question, is the COVID-19 an international pandemia? We have two answers. Yes or no. Yes, it is. No, it isn't. Ahora, la pregunta es, ¿por qué acá yo uso it? Uso este pronombre it. Este it se refiere al sujeto de esta oración. ¿De quién estamos hablando? Estamos hablando del COVID-19. Este COVID is a virus. Y si hace virus, lo tenemos que reemplazar por un pronombre, ese pronombre va a ser it. Entonces decimos, yes, it is. No, it isn't. Are we at home taking classes? Yes, we are. No, we aren't. Am I a patient of high risk because I suffer from asthma? Yes, I am. Oh, no, I'm not. Now try these questions. Where are my books? Yes? Suppose that you have this question. Where are my books? ¿Cómo la responderían? ¿De qué estoy hablando? ¿Sobre quién estoy preguntando? Estoy preguntando sobre my books. My books. Si yo tuviera que reemplazarlos por un pronombre, ¿por qué pronombre lo reemplazo? Son muchos books. El único pronombre que denota pluralidad es they. ¿Yes? Entonces podríamos decir, They. ¿Y el verbo to be para they? ¿Cuál es? Siguiente cuestión. They is, they am o they are. They are. So, they are. They are over there. Yes, por allá. They are over there. Go with this one. Why is your mom at the hospital? Why is your mom at the hospital? Acuérdense que este why quiere pregunta por qué. ¿Sí? Y para responder un why siempre necesitamos because. Ok, ¿por qué está tu mamá en el hospital? Because, para hablar de mi mamá, ¿qué pronombre utilizo? She. Because she is a patient, because she is a nurse, because she is a doctor, because she is infected. Am I infected, doctor? No, you aren't, thanks God. Is it clear? Antes de seguir adelante con el verb to be, quiero que les quede bien en claro esto. Y acá les voy a pedir que si necesitan, frenen, rebobinen. Retrocedan, tomen nota, ¿sí? Las tres formas que toma el verbo to be, ¿sí? Y acá recuerden, am lo vamos a usar para la primera persona, I am, is solamente para she, he, and it, y are para they, we, and you. ¿Yes? Eso que quede clarito. Now yes, let's continue with the past. Yes, the past of verb to be. Am, is, and are the present forms. Yes, but in the past, this verb is different. Yes, so when we use am, now we are going to use was. Where we use is, now we are going to use was. And where we use are in the past, we will use were. Yes, so pay attention that verb to be in the past only has two forms, was and were. Was, para I, para she, para he, and it, and were, for you, they, and we. De vuelta a esto, anótenlo, tomen sus propias notas. For example, affirmative form. The Ebola was a pandemia in Nigeria in 2012. We were at home for classes last year. I was a patient of high risk because I suffered from asthma. Yes, here you have the affirmative form. Now the negative. Yes, the Ebola wasn't a pandemia in Nigeria in 2012. We weren't at home for classes last year. I wasn't a patient of high risk because I suffered from asthma. Here we have the negatives. Yeah? Here it's the same. You can use a contraction like weren't or wasn't, or you can use the formal form were not or was not. That is your choice. Now the interrogative. Was the Ebola a pandemia in Nigeria in 2012? De vuelta, el mismo formato, el mismo sistema, digamos. Este was pasa adelante, ¿sí? Y al final ponemos el signo de pregunta. Were we at home for classes last year? And the answers. Was the Ebola a pandemia in Nigeria? Two options. Yes? Two options. Yes? Yes, it was. No, it wasn't. Were we at home for classes last year? Yes, we were. No, we weren't. Was I a patient of high risk because I suffered from asthma? Yes, I was. No, I wasn't. And now let's try these questions. Where were my books? Where were my books? Yesterday. Last week. Yes, la semana pasada, ayer. Where were my books? Okay. They were in the classroom. What was the problem yesterday? What was the problem? I crashed the car, Dad. Where were you born? ¿Se acuerdan de esta pregunta? Where were you born? I was born in Venezuela. Yes? Okay, well, this was a quick and simple revision of verb to be in present and in past. Yes? I repeat, stop the video, take notes, yes, as many times as you need. I hope you find it useful and see you soon. Yes? Bye-bye.